Today, I will talk about Parkinson's disease. What is Parkinson's disease? Parkinson's disease is a slowly progressive neurodegenerative disease of insidious onset. This was discovered by or explained or described by James Parkinson in 1870. He described the detail of Parkinson's disease, and to honor him, this disease was known as Parkinson's disease. He described shaking palsy, and it was later named after him, that is Parkinson's disease. And to honor him, World Parkinson's Day is observed on 11th April, that is on his birthday. So now, incidence is 8 to 18 per 1 lakh of population. Age is above 60 years. That is, incidence occurs in population above 60 years. Male-female ratio is, males are more affected, that is, they are affected 2 times. Then female. Male-female ratio is 2:1. Young onset Parkinson's disease. When this disease appears before 50 years, then this is known as young onset Parkinson's disease. And Parkinson plus syndrome, that is symptoms of this Parkinson's disease plus symptoms of other neurodegenerative diseases, are collectively known as Parkinson plus syndrome. Classification or say types of Parkinson disease is idiopathic. It is classified in 2 ways. First is idiopathic or primary Parkinson disease. In this, idiopathic or primary cause is not known, but environmental factors and genetic factors are involved. Secondary type of Parkinson's disease, in this case cause is known, and this may be due to cerebral arteriosclerosis, complication of some disease, encephalitis, neurosyphilis or Wilson disease, or it may be due to complication of drugs, reserpine, phenothiazine, etc. In another way, it is classified dopamine, depending upon dopamine. As this Parkinson's disease is due to dopamine defect, it is classified accordingly. That is, first is impaired release of dopamine. This may be idiopathic due to drug, due to toxin. And second is blockage of striatal dopamine. Blockage of striatal dopamine receptors, this is phenothiazine, and then damage to striatal neurons. The 3 types are there. This is the classification of Parkinson's disease. This risk factors are family history, pesticides, exposure to pesticides or head injury. Risk factors are family history, pesticides or head injury. Factors which reduces the risk of Parkinsonism are smoking, drinking tea and coffee, and exercise in adult age. Exercise will help this. This will reduce the risk of Parkinson's disease. Staging of Parkinson's disease. There are many methods, but no one is widely accepted, and one is just to mention Braak staging. That is, in Braak staging, Lewy bodies are present in early stage. Lewy bodies are present in olfactory bulb, medulla and pons. Early stage, as disease progresses, these bodies will appear in another part of brain, substantia nigra, other nuclei of basal ganglia, etc. These bodies will appear. And In earlier stage, that only non-motor defect is seen, and later on, motor defects are also present. And in advanced case, these bodies are presenting neocortex. Now, features of this Parkinson's disease. P for postural disturbance. A, this is akinesia. R, rigidity. And T for tremor. Part. P for posture, A for akinesia, R for rigidity, and T for tremor. These four features are characteristic of Parkinson's disease. Characteristic of Parkinson's disease. The main thing is defect in dopamine. We know that for a smooth function of muscle activity, dopamine, and there is a balance between dopamine and acetylcholine. Okay, the features are non-motor. Non-motor means there is disturbance in sleep, emotional disturbance, thought disturbance in early stages, and these are non-specific, and therefore these symptoms are overlooked. In later stage, in advanced stage, dementia will appear, and memory is intact up to terminal stage. The symptoms are divided into hyperkinetic features, hypokinetic features. Hyperkinetic features, that is, there is resting tremor. Resting tremor means when patient is at rest, then there is shaking. There is tremor is occurring. This is known as resting tremor. And this resting tremor is specific of this Parkinson's disease. In other, there is intestinal tremor, cerebellar disease, or this fine tremor in case of thyrotoxicosis. Then rigidity. Rigidity is characteristic of this Parkinson's disease. Lead pipe rigidity occurs in lower limb. That is, there is continuous resistance. There is, when it is, when this is when it, there is resistance. There is resistance or continuous resistance. When there is continuous resistance. And number is, this is in lower limb. Quagmire means this is occurring, then there is resistance. Then this will become free. Then again resistance. And then free. This is quagmire appearance. Quagmire rigidity. It is seen in upper limb. This is rigidity. And neck muscles become rigid, and therefore neck muscle and face, head or trunk, all these things behave as a one piece. And when the patient is asked to see on the left side, then he will move to his left side or right side. This is rigidity. And hypokinetic feature, akinesia, this will explain mask-like face, there is no expression is there, and then micrographia, small writing, writing will become small. This is micrographia. Then there is festinate gait and shuffling gait. Festinate gait means he will move like this, festinate gait, and then or shuffling gait. Retropulsion or lateropulsion or propulsion. That is when patient is pushed in this way, that he will go back. This is not proper. And then pill rolling movements. This is pill rolling movement. And then loss of associated movements. Loss of associated movement means when a person is walking, hands are swimming like this. This movement is associated movement, and these movements are absent in case of Parkinson's disease. So So null motor, motor, and then things which are not affected. That is a special sensor, cranial nerves, sphincters, reflexes, and memory are not affected. They are not affected. How to diagnose now? How to diagnose this disease? History and clinical examination will reveal that, will confirm the diagnosis. CT scan is of no use and MRI is helpful. Now treatment portion. Treatment portion, the disease is not cured, and only drugs will reduce the symptoms and the disease will progress. It has, drugs have no effect on progression of the disease. Only thing that it will reduce the symptom. Dopamine is used, but dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. Therefore, another form, that is levodopa, is given with other drugs to exert their effects. And when there is progressive degeneration of neurons, this medication also fails. Then stereotactic surgery may be tried. There may be stereotactic surgery with not very proper. Then prognosis. Other things, that is yoga, exercises, and other things like that, is not diet, a special diet for this Parkinson's disease. They are not recommended. They are recommended, but there is no proof that this is useful in this disease. And prognosis. Prognosis is Parkinson's disease is not fatal, but its complications are fatal. And life expectancy, once diagnosed, life expectancy is reduced. And red tulip is the symbol of this Parkinson's disease. This is about this Parkinson's disease. Okay, thank you.